Well, good evening. Welcome to Cedar Heights Baptist. If you're a guest with us, we're so glad that you're here. Tonight is just going to be a night full of praise from preschool all the way up to senior adults, all right? So we want to see God lifted high, remember the reason for the season, and that's just our goal tonight. So we're going to go ahead and get started. This right here, as you can see behind me, this is Music Time, our preschoolers, and they are directed by Ms. Jackie Williams and Ms. Monica Mathis.
Thank you.
What a beautiful job. So great. All right, next we have our praise kids. They are directed by Miss Mary Winters, and there's a slew of folks that help her. I'll try to remember. If I miss one, call it out, all right? We have Miss Highland Pickett that helps, Miss Jennifer Furry that helps, Miss Amanda Rotnick that helps, Carrie Rotnick that helps. Who else am I missing? Beth Martin, there she is. Ariel Schaffler, I told you there's a slew of folks that help with these kids, but they, what was that? Beverly Shadle, that's right. Oh my gosh. Okay, so there's a whole bunch of folks that help with these kids, and they do a phenomenal job. And I promise you, you will be blessed. So let's give the praise kids your attention.
Christmas. We are the Praise Kids, and we are so excited to lead you in worship tonight.
Worship is a huge part of Christmas. The angels worship, the shepherds worship, even the fancy wise men came and worshiped Jesus.
You guys are right. Christmas is a great time to sing worship songs.
What's the song that the angels sang to the shepherds?
We should sing it.
Glory, they sang glory to God in highest heaven and peace on earth to those whom God is pleased. That's us. Let's give God the glory.
Yeah.
the Christmas story talks about light a lot.
True. The shepherds saw a great big light when the angels came to tell them about Jesus.
And the wise men followed a star. That's a kind of light.
It makes sense. Jesus came to be light to a world that was dark and full of sin. And it all started in Bethlehem in a lowly manger bed.
The story of Jesus didn't stop right then in Bethlehem. He grew up and lived a terrific life, and he completed his mission by dying on the cross for us.
God named his son Emmanuel, which means God is with us. The whole point of Jesus' birth was to bring God down to us.
Wherever God's people are, God's there too.
Jesus is here right now. He's here to help us and to save us.
A little town of Bethlehem, If the parents of these beautiful children will stand up so they can find you, they are going to come sit with you right now.
As they are coming to set up, I'd like to read, Michael asked me to read a passage of scripture. This is from Luke chapter 2, and this is from the New Living Translation. Sometimes when you come into this season and you've heard the story a few times, more than a few times for some of us, it helps to reread it in a fresh translation, and so hopefully tonight if it sounds a little bit different than what you remember, it's okay. It's still the Word of God. It's just a slightly different translation, okay? So this is Luke chapter 2. At that time, the Roman Emperor Augustus decreed that a census should be taken throughout the Roman Empire. This was the first census taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All returned to their own towns to register for this census. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee, and he took with him Mary, his fiancée, who was obviously pregnant by this time. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no guest room for them. That night, some shepherds were in the fields outside the village guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terribly frightened, but the angel reassured them. "Do not be afraid," he said. "I bring you good news of great joy for everyone. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born tonight in the Bethlehem, the city of David. And this is how you will recognize him. You will find a baby lying in a manger, wrapped snugly in strips of cloth." Suddenly the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God. "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to all whom God favors." When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Come on, let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this wonderful thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They ran to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger. Then the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angels had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished, but Mary quietly treasured these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their fields and flocks, glorifying and praising God for what the angels had told them, and because they had seen the child, just as the angel said. As we continue this night of worship and night of celebration, of reflecting on the coming of our Lord and anticipating his second coming, my prayer is that in this season of familiarity, that we won't overlook the obvious things, that we won't make it too complicated. The big picture is that there was a baby in a manger, and that baby changed the world. And so as we continue to listen tonight, I pray that your heart will be touched by the Holy Spirit of the living God.
Well, as the adult choir and youth choir are making their way out, I'm going to ask everyone to stand and grab your hymnals and turn to hymn number 87 as we sing "Joy to the World."
This story begins with silence.
A long silence that lasted 400 years, 4 centuries of waiting to hear from the God we worshiped.
God had not spoken. No prophet had given us a fresh word from him. No king had shown us the way to him. We prayed, offered our sacrifices, and kept the festivals and holy days.
But there was only silence and waiting.
As we waited, our people looked to the ancient text that told of another time of silence and waiting.
God, creating and breathing life in the world.
We looked to our ancient heroes of faith and centuries of slavery in Egypt. We remembered the night of our liberation when the death angel passed over.
We relived the Red Sea crossing and our wandering through the wilderness when Jehovah was life.
A succession of kings ruled over us, and the more we turned away from putting God on the throne, the more desperately we needed him.
Finally, the nation was destroyed, not by enemies who conquered us, but by our own unfaithfulness to the one who had given us everything.
Yet even in our destruction, God had promised we would not be forgotten. A son would be given, a savior would come.
The silence would be broken and God would speak.
Every longing and need we had would be met as his spirit breathed new life into our world.
At last, the wait would be over. Every prophecy would be fulfilled. And the most amazing part of it, the two of us would be chosen to help bring it to pass.
Sins release us, let
Who would have imagined that God would break his silence in the way that he did, or that Mary would hear his message from an angel's lips? He said, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will give birth to a son. Call him Jesus."
The Spirit gave me the words to answer. At that very moment, when Joseph was weighing on what to do about my situation, he would be told in a dream, "Don't be afraid. Mary will have a son. Call him Jesus.
He will save his people from their sins."
Hear the song of heaven.
Caesar's decree came at the worst possible time. Mary is nearing the time to deliver her child. Our journey to Bethlehem to register was difficult for her. Everything she had been called to do was difficult. Already, she had endured scorn, mistrust, and danger. But when God called, she simply answered, yes.
God had carried me through these 9 months of being an outcast and the target of endless gossip. Faith had given me peace when Joseph doubted me. Faith had provided strength and courage as we traveled to Bethlehem. I had faith. I trusted God. Still, I will confess, there were moments I had doubts about a God who would give such a task to someone like me.
Traveled cold and weary, with a babe inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you have come and chosen me now to carry your son. I am waiting in a silent prayer. I am frightened by the load I bear in a world as cold as stone. Must I walk this path alone? Be with me now. Be with me now. Breath of heaven, hold me together. Be forever near me. Breath of breath of heaven. Do you wonder, as you watch my face, if a wiser one should have had my place? But I help.
Jesus had come into the world in the exact way God had planned it all along. Everything about him was perfect despite of difficult circumstances.
Suddenly, there were shepherds peering through the doorway of the stable. When they saw Mary and me and the baby in Mary's arms, they came in and fell to their knees before him, and they worshiped him. Many years later, John would write, "The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. Mary and I were the first to see it. Then the shepherds that came in from the hills that night caught a glimpse."
And ever since then, people have found their way to him, one way or another. When they see him for who and what he really is, they love him. For what would we have done if he hadn't come to us in the way that he did?
Breaking, how we need to hear from God. You've been promised, we've been waiting. Welcome, Holy Child. Welcome, Holy Child. Hope that you don't mind our name. Oh,
We didn't know it, but wealthy men were already on their way to honor him. They brought precious gifts to lay at his feet.
Heaven's son was worthy of even more.
He deserves everything we hold dear.
So we let go of all we value, all we cling to.
We lay down anything that keeps us from surrendering our lives to him.
Because the truth is, Heaven's son is worth even more.
Well, amen. They did a great job, right? It's been a wonderful evening full of worship to the one that is worthy. And it's been our prayer that you wouldn't see us up here on this stage, that you would see God revealed in this place this evening. So I think God has answered that prayer, And God is definitely with us. I do want to recognize a few people. If our actors would come out, they were really shy. We worked with them. They did a great job. Also want to extend a personal thank you to our sound and our light people in the back. This wouldn't be possible without them. And so we thank all of our families for being here and all of our friends. Let me lead us in a word of prayer, and we'll be dismissed, okay? Father God, we love you so much, God, and it's such a privilege to be in your house tonight, God, to sing praises to your name, God, and to hear praises being sung to your name. God, I pray that you would just bless each and every family here, God, and we would remember the reason for the season is not about gifts or Santa Claus, God, but it's all about you and the sacrifice that you made sending a son to die a cruel death. God, we thank you for who you are, God, and we can't thank you enough for all that you do. We pray all this in your son's name. Amen. You are dismissed. Be safe.